are again in the shroud of the Avatar. Today, just a quick showing of the planes of righ, which we have just here. It's on the island of the Hidden Vale. So if we just show that on SOTA maps so you get an idea. Just come on down. And here we go. Is Knightsport. Then the plains of Innis are, just trying to find them on the map. Let's have a look around. Just have a look up here. So it will place right there, which you just walk up, crossroads, carry on straight, and you can't miss it. Let's say just to the left of righ. So there we go. Go back to the plains, and then we'll enter. Here we are, just being attacked. Beginning part of this instance, you'll see spiders and skeletons. And as we go through, the zone has a variety of creatures in it. I find the mixture of skeletons and spiders just a bit too much, so I head towards the back. As you can see, we've got some wolves, which they'll run anyway. Spider, couple of spiders. Attack skeleton. There we go. Let's take the skeleton. Nice rusty sword. Nice 50 gold. We'll break it down for scrap metal. Of course, spider silk is the handy thing for me. It's used in the fire spells that I use. Let's see. We're looking for, oh, that happens, you're just about to leave the instance, which is not what we want to do, so we must be in the top corner. So we can see some trees over here. There must be wolves in the area. We'll take the cotton bush. I can see some wolves over here. And here comes a pack. It's a good area. There we go. cotton. Sometimes gotta be careful of wolves, because they are pack animals. When they see weakness, they will attack. But they are handy because they give a lot of loot, especially when you get skills up. The hides used for leather, the wolf carcasses, which are worth 4 if you butcher them, they double their money, and of course a wolf head, which again can be crafted. Some people use them for headgear, craft them so you can have a wolf headgear. Take a tree. So somebody took down some skeletons. Now with the skeletons, they can look like this normally when they're just asleep. I know that these aren't asleep because they've got the word corpse at the end. And if somebody else doesn't want them, we might as well take them. Maybe the wolves probably could have killed them. And let's just see. Here they come. Good. Show you the plains of Ryanis at the same time. We only got animal hide on that one. There's some carcasses, a bit of civet used in cooking. See if we can trap these wolves. Have a look around. There's a cotton bush. There's a tree. Oh, another wolf back there. Say, all the items in the game used in crafting, so you can use them yourself, or of course you can sell them to other players or the NPCs. And another one. chances of rising. But we do have to keep an eye on the focus. Say this is a 3-skull instance, so it's a good place to come after you've got to grips with the 1-star instance at Crossroads and the other parts on this island. Let's have a look. So there's some skeletons over here. Spiders, which are not my favourite mix. Nice little two on that one. Symbol on them. So sometimes if you find you're not hitting them, just see if you've got the little target symbol on them. There's a skeleton over here. Oh, spider here. Let's just take on this spider. More spiders. I find I'm not that great against spiders. At least we can get some spider silk out of them. Nice. at this one. That's all there is to the plains, really. Did want to come over here. Oh, yeah, thought I did see it. If you look very carefully, you'll get to know some of the other regents in the game, but they're hard to find. Now, it's a little stalk here. We can see it's harvestable, because it's giving off a little signal. And also, if we move the mouse over it, it turns into a sickle. So when you're in the game, it's worth just slowing down and looking out for them, because they are hard to find, but once you know where they are, they always spawn in the same place. And the other thing in the game, as a new player, is when night falls, it's best to go back, do some crafting, just to wait for the next daylight to come up, because you perform worse at night than day. But this is a good zone, as a three skull zone, to do after you've got used to these other two areas, which are one skuller instances. You have King's Road here, and then just up here you've got the North Vale Way. So as a new player, if you use these two areas, and then you can go on to the plains of righ Innis next, as your character is improving. And of course it's handy area, because you've got the main trading hub of Owl's Head just up here. So there's everything you need as a new player to get yourself started and established in the game. Right. That's where we'll finish that video. Thanks for watching. Please do like, subscribe, and leave comments. And have a good day.